right, ready to go with another day of CWA Championship Wrestling. Boy, today we've got one for you. The very large, very powerful Soul Taker will be here in a handicap match today. Rock and Roll Express will be going against the Wild Side. Is that some kind of match coming up or not? Following that, the Blackbirds will be here. Also a six-man match. But to get things underway today, we have coming in here the Dirty White Boy and Mike Davis to go against Dutch Mantell and the King. Back with that opening match in just a moment. Team action coming up and coming through those curtains right now. The Dirty White Boy and the Dirty White Girl. Dirty White Boy, the holder of the CWA Heavyweight Championship. Mike Davis going to be his partner today. He's back, says CWA Heavyweight Champion is what it says. As Mike Davis climbs into the ring, Dirty White Boy not far behind. Here comes Dutch Mantell and the King, Jerry Lawler, with him. Looking forward to this one, boy. Tag team match, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun will be refereeing this one. The Dirty White Boy. I don't know if you can hear all of that. Lawler has just told the Dirty White Boy, hey, she's in the corner. If she even thinks about interfering in this match, you're going to slap the lipstick off her face, I think he said. Anyway, the clear message is that she should stay out of the action and stay in the corner where she belongs. Going to be a valet out here. Dirty White Boy steps out of the ring. Mike Davis stays in. The King steps in. And we are underway. One fall, 10-minute time limit match. Mike Davis, the Rock and Roll RPM. Facing the King. Back in the corner goes the King. Davis with a big forearm. That was no forearm there. That was a fist he hit him with. Uses the arm drag to peel him out of the corner. Lawler backs him into a corner and returns the favor. And he says, hey, I can do the same thing. You want to go flying through the air, here you go. And Mike Davis over to the corner makes the tag on the Dirty White Boy. Dirty White Boy, as we have already told you a couple of times, the holder of the CWA Heavyweight Championship belt. He won it in a tournament. Davis and Dirty White Boy. Some sort of conversation between them. Referee didn't like it much because Dirty White Boy doubled up that right fist and the referee said, open hand. Crowd getting behind the King and Dutch Mantell. Distraction by Mike Davis as the referee. Oh, look at this. Look on the left of your screen. Dirty White Girl grabbing the boot of Lawler, holding him back in a corner while the Dirty White Boy nails him with a right fist. Lawler got out of the corner, back over near his corner, close to Dutch Mantell. Lawler is mighty upset. He came out of the ring, and he was headed for the Dirty White Girl. Dirty White Boy jumped in between her and the approaching Lawler. The referee has set everybody back in the ring. Dirty White Girl, she better not interfere in the match. If she is caught at it, it will be immediate disqualification for the team of Dirty White Boy and Mike Davis. Dirty White Boy, Lawler, tie it up, back in the rope. White Boy fires him into the rope. Now they're both going. Lawler slides out of the ring. The Dirty White Girl looked like she was headed on the way to trip Lawler. Lawler, instead of hitting the ropes, just slid under the rope and went after her. She immediately ran behind the Dirty White Boy. Lawler now heading back up on the ring apron, through the ropes and into the ring. Jerry Calhoun right behind Dirty White Boy up there. We're about 3 minutes into this action. Once again, the crowd says, go Jerry, go Dutch. Speaking of Dutch, the tag is made. This is his first official appearance in the match as he comes in and nails the dirty white boy. Big right fist. Tag made, and Mike Davis comes in. Davis greeted by Dutch Mantel with a couple of right hands, and boom, into the double boots of Lawler over in the corner. Mike Davis, snap suplex by Dutch Mantel, has a cover by the Dutchman, but Davis hit him with a fist in the eye. He calls for a boot from the dirty white boy. Tag made. They got Dutch back in their corner. Dirty white boy with a right fist to the midsection. The clothesline as Dutch comes off the ropes. There's a cover one. Well, Lawler is here to break it up. 4 minutes gone in this one. Remember, it's a 10-minute time limit match. Great tag team action to get things going today on CWA Championship Wrestling. Lots more to come. Stay with us. Dutch ducks under the double clothesline. Powers them both down to the mat. Goes for the cover on Mike Davis and then instead heads for Lawler and makes the tag on it. Lawler grabs them both, heads together. A cover by Lawler on the dirty white girl. Dirty white girl jumps in. The referee sees it. And she has just gotten that team disqualified. Oh, the dirty white boy nailed Lawler from behind as he went after her. She's out of the ring. Lawler going after dirty white boy. Dutch after Mike Davis. And the white boy and Mike Davis lead the hands raised by disqualification. Dutch Mantel and the King are going to walk out of here with a victory in 4 minutes, 44 seconds. 4:44, the King and Dutch Mantel have themselves a win as they chase the dirty white boy, the dirty white girl, and Dutch Mantel out of here. So they are, they're gone. Here they come back. Let's see what they have to say about it. Looks like everybody's chasing you these days, huh?
Well, hey, Dave Brown, when you got something that looks this gorgeous and this beautiful, step right up here, buddy, so everybody can see you. Naturally, they're going to chase you. And when you're the CWA heavyweight champion, you're sitting on top of the hill, looking down at all the rest, and naturally, everybody's going to be coming after you.
You know, I get the idea you think that hanging onto this belt is going to be a cakewalk. Maybe let me just show you the top two contenders. How about that? Here's one of them right here.
Put him out.
Good morning. It's 7 o'clock straight up and down. Time to get up and get going. Rock and roll time. Born to be my baby. You know it. Bon Jovi. Good morning.
Jeff Jarrett there, number one contender, huh?
That's the number one contender, Mr. Pretty Boy himself.
You got it.
Jeff Jarrett, by the time
hey, white boy, don't mess up his face here.
Get up, Jeff.
What?
Get up,
okay. Get up. Jeff Jarrett, I'm going to beat you up so bad, boy. Your mama ain't going to be able to recognize you. Because your daddy couldn't get it, the job done. And what makes that skinny, blonde-headed punk think that he can walk in the ring and take this from a dirty white boy?
If you're not impressed by Jeff Jarrett.
No, I'm not impressed.
How about the number two contender? Take
Let's
a look
see.
At this.
Body to body. Body to body. Nobody does it like you do. Body to body.
There's the number two contender, Kerry Von Erich.
Hey, I hope you don't think that big horse-headed geek's cute or good-looking. That's what I thought. Kerry Von Erich, worldwide famous. What else can you say, baby? Crawl in the ring with me, baby. Hey, I've took on muscle-bound geeks before. Because, baby, you're looking at a man right now that knows how to take it to the street, knows how to rumble, and knows how to get down and get nasty. So you can bring all your big, pretty muscles out there. You can flex for all these sweat hogs out here. And it ain't going to do you a bit of good, baby, because you've got to step in the ring against the CWA heavyweight champion, and that's a dirty white boy, baby. And then after I get through taking care of these two idiots, Jerry Lawler, eventually, baby, you're going to have to crawl back in the ring with me. It's just a matter of time because, hey, I am the man on top of the hill looking down at all the rest. So, gentlemen, just a little word for you. Beat me if you can. It's time to rumble. It's been your pleasure.
He has the belt. The question is, can he hang on to it? Back in just a moment with the Soul Taker.
CWA Championship Wrestling coming your way in Owensboro, Kentucky. The Owensboro Sports Center on Sunday, November 5th. We'll have more about that next week. This Thursday night, Henryville, Indiana. All your favorite CWA stars coming to the Henryville High School this Thursday night. Let's talk about Evansville, Indiana. Wednesday night at the Coliseum. Seven big matches. Kevin Dillinger takes on RPM Mike Davis. Superstar Bill Dundee and Freddie take on the Wild Side with Ronnie P. Gossett. Dutch Mantell takes on the Soul Taker, who's been running roughshod throughout our area. Listen to this. In Evansville Wednesday night, the loser of this match will be powdered and diapered in the middle of the ring. Jeff Jarrett takes on Ronnie P. Gossett. The CWA Tag Team belts on the line. Rock and Roll Express with a score to settle against the Blackbirds. That'll all come down Wednesday night at the Coliseum. Also, the CWA Heavyweight Championship on the line. Dirty White Boy puts his title on the line. Dirty White Girl in his corner against the modern-day warrior, Kerry Von Erich, and Evansville Wednesday night. Plus, after all that, an 18-man Renegade Battle Royal, $5,000 to the winner.
Evansville, Indiana, the land of high waters and low brains. Let me tell you something, Jeff Jarrett, you wimp. If you think you're going to powder and diaper this big carcass, you're in for a rude awakening. I've got a score to settle with you from a long way back. And for you sweat hogs that haven't seen Jeff Jarrett's behind, and believe me, there are very few, you'll get a good chance to see him in Evansville, Indiana. And after I powder and diaper Jeff, I'm going to split the $5,000 battle royal with my Wild Side.
Also, the CWA title on the line.
And I'll tell you right up front who's going to win the big Renegade Battle Royal. And then, baby, after I win that, I'm going to give you $5,000 to go party on, buy you a little something. But Kerry Von Erich, jump on your plane there in Texas and fly on up, boy, to that new building they're supposed to be reinvigorating or whatever you call it, however you do it, that dump up there. Come on up, baby. And you step in the ring with the CWA heavyweight champion, baby, and deal with me if you can, because, baby, the odds are in my favor.
Got a match coming up here. Stepping up toward the ring area should be the very large Soul Taker in just a moment. Matter of fact, not only is this a match, it's a handicap match. You've got Freezer Thompson up there at about 289 pounds. You got David Johnson. It's going to be two against one here with the big Soul Taker. The Soul Taker out of Larry Sharp's Monster Factory up in New Jersey. And the Soul Taker climbs through the ropes, kind of taking his own time. This guy is big. He is big and solid, let me tell you. Those tattoos all over both arms. And both of them, Johnson and Thompson, head for the Soul Taker. The Soul Taker, just look at this, just kind of shaking them off. Johnson hit him with a right hand. Soul Taker just knocked him down to the mat. Thompson goes into the ropes. Whoa, Soul Taker just knocks him down to the mat. The Soul Taker, and look at this, Johnson again with a right and then a left, and they just bounce off the chest of the Soul Taker, who with the knee then puts David Johnson down. Look at this! A big slam on Freezer Thompson, almost 300 pounds worth. The Soul Taker has just stepped in the ring. and has just totally controlled not one opponent, but two of them. Johnson tried the forearm across the chest. That didn't work at all. Look at this guy. Oh, my goodness. Thompson was thrown into the ropes and flipped through those ropes down onto the floor. David Johnson left alone with a soul taker. David trying his best. Those right hands, the forearms, the fist, nothing is having any effect on this soul taker who now picks David up. Oh, goodness. Down to one, two. Boy, it was pretty obvious that that was going to wrap that one up. 1 minute, 35 seconds of total destruction by the soul taker against Freezer Thompson and David Johnson in the handicap match. The man is awesome, no doubt about it. We'll be back with more on CWA Championship Wrestling.
Championship Wrestling fans, Sunday, November 5th, Owensboro, Kentucky, the Owensboro Sports Cena, CWA action headed your way. This Thursday night, Henryville, Indiana, at the high school gym, a big card of action, all your favorite CWA stars in Henryville. And Tuesday night, that's this Tuesday night, in Paducah, Kentucky, at Tillman High School, the high school gym, all your favorite CWA stars will be in Paducah Tuesday night. Let's talk about Evansville Coliseum Wednesday night. Seven big matches, Kevin Dillinger against RPM Mike Davis. Superstar Bill Dundee and Freddie take on the wild side with Ronnie Pete Gossett, Dutch Mantell against the Soul Taker. Loser of this match, powdered and diapered in the middle of the ring, Jeff Jarrett against Ronnie P. Gossett. CWA tag battle as a big grudge match, the Rock and Roll Express title on the line against the Blackbirds. CWA Heavyweight Championship, Kerry Von Erich comes into town to battle the new champion, the Dirty White Boy, with a dirty white girl in his corner. Plus, an 18-man Renegades Battle Royal, $5,000 going to the winner. All this action coming up Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum. Be there.
Right now, the match which occurred between the Blackbirds and Rick Morton and Robert Gibson, the Rock and Roll Express. Take a look.
Morton up. Big atomic knee drop. Nailed King Parsons. Parsons down to the mat. Morton tagging it out with Robert Gibson. Sunset flip. Robert Gibson, two. Brickhouse Brown breaks it up to count of two. All four men back in here again. Robert Gibson again going for the pin cover. Has him pinned. Calhoun's over in the corner. As Brickhouse sends Gibson right over the top rope. Disqualification. Brown and Iceman King Parsons. Those double teamings going on inside the ring with Brickhouse Brown, Iceman King Parsons. Reggie B. Fine in there just nailed Ricky Morton in the midsection with that cane. Reggie B. Fine now going down into a sock. It looks like some type of a metal file. It looks like a metal file. They're going to work on the head of Ricky Morton. Iceman King Parsons, Brickhouse Brown in there, just busted Ricky Morton's head open with a metal file, throws him back out of the ring again. As Morton busted open in bad trouble. Robert Gibson down at ringside was just nailed with the cane and Reggie B. Fine. Double team going on the outside of the ring. Just threw Ricky Morton into that railing around the ring. In comes Dustin Rhodes and Dutch Mantell, clearing the tag team of the Blackbirds out of here.
Happiest of times right now for Rock and Roll Express, Rick Morton and Robert Gibson, as they head this way. They still have those CWA Tag Team Championship belts around their waist, but I think you can tell right here by looking, Rick is not the happiest person in the world right now.
Well, Dave, first of all, I'd like to start off, you know, me and Robert wrestled all over the world, brother, defending belts. No matter where we went to, we were champions, and we wrestled as champions. But you know, it come to a point with the Blackbirds here that it went beyond wrestling. Take a look at my face, for instance, right here. They used this right here. They come right in the ring, Dave Brown, and took this right here and put it upside my face. Now, boys, you call that professional wrestling? Do you call that professional wrestling? That's what I want to know. Now, you are man enough to come in the ring behind our backs and take us down and pull out something like this right here and scrape my face with it. Now, the sights could have been set on Robert. We know it could have happened to him, either one. It don't matter. I don't know if you just picked me out to do it to me. But let me tell you something, big boys. If you're man enough to do it, you're man enough to come out here today. You're man enough to come out here and look me in the eyes and tell us, brother, that you are a better tag team than the Rock and Roll Express. We don't think you are. So if you got the courage, the guts, buddy, come on out here right now, and we will end this. Brother, we don't care. It won't cost nobody out here an extra dime. We just go ahead and we'll end it right now. If you have got the guts, Blackbirds, you say that you're the greatest tag team that ever happened. Come on out here and show us just how great you are.
Wait a minute. Reggie, be fine. Don't want any trouble out here.
Hold it. What is you, a man or a mouse? What you out here crying for?
Now, hold this up, Dave Brown, where I can talk.
Why is you out here crying for? You got something? Don't worry about the black bear. The black bears are very busy right now. I'm representing the black bear. I'm ready to be fine. I'm one of a kind, baby. You low budget, shut up while I'm talking. You understand? Hold up. You wait a minute. I'm talking to you.
I want to talk to the Blackbirds.
Look, I'm representing the Blackbirds. They're under my contract. They do what I say do. Right now, they're taking care of some business in the back. If you have anything to say to the Blackbird, you relay it to me.
Okay, Mr.
You know,
okay,
let me tell
you. Are you gonna delay?
I will tell them.
Okay, do me a
anything
favor.
You
just
have to
just
say.
Do me a favor.
What?
Okay, you will. Say you will delay a message to the Blackbirds for me.
You give me the message and I will delay it.
Okay. What's wrong? The message I want you to send to the Blackbirds for me, would you please? Because I cannot give it to them.
Pretty clear message, I think, from Rick Morton as he sends Reggie B. Fine packing back to deliver that to the Blackbirds. Rock and Roll with a tough match scheduled here today. As Rick and Robert climb into the ring, boy, they're fired up now. And here comes the Wild Side. Chris Champion, Mark Starr, led by General Ronnie P. Gossett. Gossett with waving that Wild Side flag and with the general...
You know, I'm glad that senile Eddie Marlin booked this match on TV because my Wild Side will finally get to embarrass the Rock and Roll before all these morons out there and in here.
Well, we'll see. We're expecting a fine, fine match as you got two of the top tag teams right here.
The top tag teams. You don't have two of them. You have my Wild Side, the CWA Tag Team Champions. Going
direction.
Against the Rock and Roll Express.
They
lost those belts, Dave Brown.
Yeah, you did. The Rock and Roll Express are the CWA Tag Team Champions.
That's your book. That's not Ronnie P. Gossett's book.
The Wild Side are the former CWA Tag They're Champions.
They're not former. They are the champions. You may convince yourself and all these big, fat slobs, these hairy-legged morons out here, but you don't convince Ronnie P. Gossett, Mr. Incompetent.
I just know who has the belt, Mr. Gossett. Who has both of them. One of them belongs to Rick Morton and the other to Robert Gibson. In there right now, Robert Gibson against Mark Starr. Look at Robert, pressing down to the mat.
Look at Robert. I don't see anything impressive about Robert. You better be looking at the Wild Side. This is the team of the future, the Wild Side.
I was looking at the Wild Side with his shoulders on the mat.
Can I get a word in without you butting in? I've watched a lot of teams in the CWA, and I am not prejudiced. Believe me, I'm as honest as the day is long. This is the most impressive team I have ever watched. You've had Jerry Lawler, Bill Dundee, you've had Jeff Jarrett, Billy Travis, you've had all kind of teams in here, but none compare with the Wild Side. I get calls all day long. My answering service stays busy. My staff works 24 hours a day. Everybody wants Ronnie Gossett and the Wild Side.
I believe that. Everybody wants to get at the Wild Side after what they have done to many of the wrestlers in the CWA.
What they done, everybody deserves what they got. And don't think for 1 minute we have forgotten that idiot Jerry Lawler and Freaky Freddy. I just put them on my list, and they'll be right back in action against them. Don't think we forgot anything they did.
Freddy's still wearing the mask, I might point out, to Ronnie P.
Which is an improvement, I'm sure.
Minute 40.
Look at Ricky Morton's face. Now, doesn't it look bad? Look at it. He got exactly what he deserved. Exactly. And had the audacity to slap Reggie B. Fine out here, an upstanding manager like myself, who comes out here to talk diplomatic to Ricky Morton, something he doesn't understand.
Nobody deserves what they did to Ricky Morton.
He got exactly what he deserved. And I might say it's an improvement. He looks better with that bandage on his face.
Rick Morton in there now against Chris Champion of the Wild Side.
Look at all these saggy bags over here. Look here. Look at them. Food stamp recipients on the front row cheering the rock and roll. That's the kind of people they relate to. Low-class individuals. You don't see my Wild Side associated with class.
I don't see too many people cheering for the Wild Side, but I see a lot of folks cheering for the Rock and Roll Express.
That's
Rick Morton,
because
Robert
we
Gibson.
Don't associate with these Memphis morons. We have more class, something you've never heard of.
Ronnie P. Gossett with the words of wisdom here
today.
You know,
this station must have a lot of compassion because they have kept you here for many years. That's exactly the reason, compassion, because as a commentator, you are lousy. You can't even tell the weather.
General Ronnie P. Gossett, the man with the sergeant stripes on his sleeves.
You can look at Calhoun. Naturally, he's out of position. That ought to be a submission right there. And what's Calhoun doing? His usual nothing.
Submission? Where do you get submission out of a headlock there? That's can be done, but it sure isn't easy to get a wrestler to give up with a headlock.
You notice that move by the Wild Side. Do you tell me that's not devastating? These guys train every day. I have them up every morning at 5 o'clock. They run, they do 35 squats a day. They're in fantastic shape.
I believe that part. They're in fantastic shape. They do have some good moves. They also have some mighty dirty moves, too.
Look at Chris Griffin in there. You've got to give us credit where credit is due. We are awesome.
This champion with Robert Gibson running him over toward the turnbuckles and reversal.
You notice that illegal move, and you're sitting here like Humpty Dumpty not saying a word about that.
Illegal? I didn't see any
illegal
move. What was illegal about it?
He pulled a man's hair for one thing. You didn't see that?
I didn't. I sure didn't. Down to the mat. Oh, Robert
notice
Gibson.
Notice this teamwork, the greatest teamwork in the wrestling profession is right here. The Wild Side.
All four of them in there now.
You know, they didn't get that name, the Wild Side, from helping little old ladies across the street and baking cupcakes. They are the Wild Side. They live and breathe the Wild Side.
You have just told the truth. They sure don't help people across the street.
Illegal fist? You're going to sit here and say that's not illegal? Look at Ricky Morton over there with... Look at Mark Starr over there. Now here you
come
on. They see what the rock and roll is
in here.
Lay it in on them, boys. Lay it in on them. Beat their brains out.
Your team has just been disqualified, Ronnie P. Gossett, as the Blackbirds come rolling into the ring here. Reggie B. Finer manager. Look at Gossett down here on the floor. You couldn't see it, but Gossett has just nailed Robert Gibson down here at ringside. Robert picks up a chair. Here he comes back into the ring. And there goes the Wild Side. There goes the Blackbirds. Gossett is saying, come on, let's get out of here. There is Rick Morton holding onto the side of his face that the Blackbirds messed up in a previous match, and they went after him again here today. Disqualification, not much consolation. But Rick Morton and Robert Gibson have got themselves a victory. Rick needs to get that check. We'll take a break. We'll return.
Music tonight for the Blackbirds. Iceman Parsons, Brickhouse Brown, their manager Reggie DeFine, minus a shirt coming out here. Disgusting display as the Rock and Roll Express had invited them out here, but no, they wait and you jump them during the match.
That's all right. You see what happened when you mess with Reggie Fine, don't you?
Yeah.
You see what my boys did, didn't you?
I saw what you did. They jumped them during the match.
First of all, Dave Brown, I've been in this situation before myself, right here at this Unit Poop TV studio. And nobody put their head on Reggie B. Fine, because I'm going to tell you something right now. This man has invested a hell of a career with us. And it's all about money. And to come out here and rip up this man's shirt like this, I'm going to tell you something right now. Ooh, I can't wait, Rock and Roll, because I'm going to tell you, when it's all said and done, we going to have the strap, brother. It's only a matter of time. Iceman, you better tell them what they in so far, because I don't think they know.
See, what you don't understand is, out with the old and in with the new. See, Reggie Fine promised us strictly to the top now. No more in the bottom, no more in the middle. We all the way on top. You understand me? See, you send boys out here to do a man's job. Ricky Martin, Robert Gibson, you boys like toys, don't you? You ought to go down the street to Toys R Us and get your toys early for Christmas. See, so you gon' pay now, so you did the ultimate. We talking about a $300 shirt here. Nobody do that to Reggie Fine.
Let's go do what we do best, Ice. Stomp, pump, and stomp some suckers upside their nappy head.
See, if you didn't want to be a part of the cake, you had no business getting in the mix. Can you dig it? Like Mama says, it be that way sometimes, you bunch of rooted poops.
Dave Brown, you watch this. This is what's going to happen to the Rock and Roll Express Monday night.
Never mind.
We're going to watch, all right. Rock and Roll Express whenever you face them. As we've said so many times before, these teams come in here and they claim, hey, this is what we're going to do to so-and-so. Well, the Blackbirds were able to jump the Rock and Roll Express earlier today. But they didn't get to go against them one-on-one, or two against two, I guess we should say. We'll see when that match comes up in the arena. Today, the Blackbirds going against a young man we saw for the first time last week, the Dream Warrior, Kelvin Austin, and as we told you, Norvell Austin's younger brother. Norvell. Wrestler, I think many of you will remember, he and Sputnik Monroe held the old Southern Tag Championship for quite some time. His brother just hammered by Iceman Parsons. Ken Raper, Kelvin's partner, steps in the ring right now. Raper and Austin going against the Blackbird. Iceman Parsons with a boot to the head of Ken Raper. Calls for a boot in the corner from Brickhouse Brown, then makes a tag. Parsons holds Raper up. Off the middle rope comes Brickhouse Brown. Ken Raper being flipped around the ring by Brickhouse Brown. Brickhouse in the air, drops down. He had the fist doubled up. He wears a glove on that right hand, and he nailed him with it. Here comes Ken Raper flying through the ropes down under the floor, and right there, Reggie B. Fine with that cane, jabbing him in the back with it. Raper rolled back in the ring by Parsons. Brickhouse Brown waiting for him there, picks him up, makes a tag on Parsons when Parsons got back up on the apron. They double up. Now Brickhouse Brown slides out of the ring, back up in the corner, leaving the Iceman. Ken Raper battling back here. Raper
trying to get over to the corner and make tag on his partner, but Parsons able to keep him out of the corner. He had him down and looked like he might have been able to get a three count, but Reggie B. Fine said, hey, don't pin him yet. Reggie B. Fine still upset over Rick Morton smacking him. Big right fist knocks Ken Raper off his feet. Brickhouse Brown backs him under the ropes. Across the way, Brickhouse meets him head on right in the middle of the ring. Brickhouse celebrating. He hasn't gotten the pin yet, but he's already celebrating. Sure of his victory, he is. Ken Raper again back under the rope. Iceman, Brickhouse, double team. This time it's the boots. Brickhouse leaves. Iceman Parsons picks him up. Raper off the rope. Oh my goodness. Once again, the Blackbirds flying through the air and meet him head on. Brickhouse off the top rope, springs down. He got him with the right fist. There's a cover. Count of one, two. It's over. Brickhouse Brown, Iceman Parsons, totally controlling things against the younger, the less, much less experienced Ken Raper and especially Kelvin Austin. Well, the Blackbirds and Reggie B. Fine are going to come away with a victory in 3 minutes, 50 seconds. That's not all. We've still got a big six-man match coming up.
Michael St. John for CWA Championship Wrestling. I want to remind the fans in Owensboro, Kentucky, Sunday, November 5th, CWA action headed your way. This coming Thursday night, Henryville, Indiana, at the high school gym. Rock and Roll Express will be there. Dutch Mantel, Freddie, and many more in Henryville Thursday night. And also on Tuesday night, all you fans in the Paducah, Kentucky area, Cairo, Illinois, come on down. See the matches at the Tillman High School in Paducah. A big card of action. All your favorite CWA stars in Paducah Tuesday night. Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum, the site for CWA action. Listen to the card. Kevin Dillinger takes on RPM Mike Davis. Superstar Bill Dundee with Freddie will take on the Wild Side, Ronnie P. Gossett in their corner. Also, Dutch Mantel gets his shot at the Rugged Soul Taker, the newcomer that's been running roughshod throughout the area. Loser of this next match will be powdered and diapered in the middle of the ring. Yes, you heard me right. Powdered and diapered in the center of the ring as Jeff Jarrett takes on Ronnie P. Gossett. Then the CWA Tag Team Championship on the line. It'll be a grudge battle. Rock and Roll Express to take on the Blackbirds. The CWA Heavyweight title, Kerry Von Erich comes to town to challenge the new champion, the Dirty White Boy, White Girl in this corner. Plus the 18-man Renegades Battle Royal. All this action Wednesday night in Evansville. Dutch?
Well, it's going to be an interesting card. I'm going to watch the Blackbirds and the Rock and Roll lock horns, and let's see if the Rock and Roll can get even with the Blackbirds for that dirty deed they done to them. I'm going to watch Kerry Von Erich, a fellow takes in a mind, take on the Dirty White Boy, and I don't think Kerry Von Erich likes to be called a horse-faced Texan, but the biggest thing to me is taking on that Soul Taker. Now, seeing what he did to Jerry Lawler, that means I'm going to have to change my strategy Wednesday night in Evansville. After seeing him lay Jerry Lawler out in the middle of the ring, that's my big, big man. And he's from the Monster Factory, trained by Larry Sharp, so we know he knows where he's coming from, and he knows what to do in that ring. But I'm going to tell you what, I'm going to back up. And I might have to go back to my dirty, evil ways. But Soul Taker, when you climb in a ring with me, I'm going to make you run the gamut, pal. We're going to lock it up in Evansville.
Six-man tag team action about to begin. On the left over there, Rooster Cogburn, right there with the cowboy hat and the chaps on. That is Kevin Dillinger. And their partner, Keith Eric, coming out right now, Dustin Rhodes. Ready. And Big Cowboy Frazier. Six-man action. This one ought to be a good one. Some of the fan favorites in here with Dustin Rhodes, Freddie, and, of course, the Big Plowboy, 420 pounds worth out of Mississippi. Freddie out of wherever. Dustin Rhodes from Austin, Texas. Ken Dillinger just handed a branding iron, a black hat, and those chaps that he wears out of the ring. Rooster Cogburn with the bright red sunglasses. Referee Jerry Calhoun about set for this one. It's Kevin Dillinger starting against Dustin Rhodes. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the CWA wrestling action today. We had some terrific matches here. And this one promises to be just as good. Look at Dustin. Rolling that arm lock. Look at him get off his feet. Great drop kick, and down to the mat goes Kevin Dillinger, and you couldn't see his eyes, but he had a look in his eyes like, what have I gotten into? What do I do now? Well, be patient, Kevin, because Dustin Rhodes has just tagged the big cloud boy, who just kind of stuck that telephone pole arm out there and let Kevin Dillinger run into it. Dillinger over to the corner, made the tag on his partner, Keith Harris. Keith Harris ran into the plowboy. Harris, a real battler. He hasn't won a lot of matches here on Championship Wrestling, but he's been in a lot of matches all the way up to the end, if you know what I mean. He'll fight you every step of the way. Ready! Keith Eric. Well, not a lot of fight in him right now. He's trying to stay away from Freddy. Freddy with his back turned, and Keith Eric nails him with a double forearm across the back and then pops him with a right fist. Freddy in the face. Oh, a headbutt. Down to the mat went Keith Eric. Eric looking for the corner, finding the wrong one. Now, finally, he's over. He reaches for a tag, and Rooster Cogburn can't get out of the way fast enough. Shaking his head, said, hey, I don't want to go in there right now. No, thank you. We appreciate the invitation, but I am unable to attend. Ah, look out. Now Rooster sneaking up behind. He nailed Freddy with a right fist to the midsection. Father Freddy, and Rooster says, I must leave early.
And then finally just walked out of here winning the whole thing. Rock and Roll Express got a victory over the Wild Side when the Blackbirds interfered in the action today. Not a good couple of days for Rick Morton, but there will be other days, and the Blackbirds better be looking out for that. Speaking of the Blackbirds, they won their match over Ken Raper and the Dream Warrior, Kelvin Austin, today. They were just outmanned by the big Blackbirds team of Iceman Parsons and Brickhouse Brown with Reggie B. Fine, a very upset Reggie B. Fine in here as their manager. Then Dustin Rhodes, Freddie, and Plowboy Frazier in that six-man match. Action just constant in that one. But they end up getting the victory over Kevin Dillinger, Rooster Cogburn, and Keith Eric as Freddie got a submission in 7 minutes 51 seconds. There'll be more next week. We hope you'll be right here with us next week, too. Until then, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.